If your foot ends up anywhere else, call a doctor immediately because... What's going on, team? So if you're working on making your kicks a little bit better, or if you're an instructor trying to find ways to help your students make their kicks better, today's drill is really basic, really simple, but it will help you with how to position your knee for each individual kick when you're doing round kick, side kick, and hook kick. Now, as we go into this, keep in mind, I realize there's a lot of different ways that you can throw these kicks. Your way to chamber might not be the same as mine. I'm gonna show you the way I do it, but take it, modify it, and just change it based on your own kicking style. Now, getting right into the round kick, the main idea, at least for training our accuracy, is gonna be to point our knee wherever we wanna kick. So if I point my knee straight at you, and I kick out, my foot will end there because, well, that's how your body works.
It's science.
If your foot ends up anywhere else, call a doctor immediately because, well, you did something bad.
You done messed up, AA Ron!
So if I point my knee right here, I kick out, I pull back, and this is gonna help me maintain my knee chamber so I don't kick and just flop down. Gives me a point of reference to throw this out, back, and just set down under control at all times so I'm not dropping my knee or kicking off at different angles. All right, so going into the side kick, this is one that you see a lot of different knee chambers for. This is the way we do it. So I'm gonna take my heel and I'm gonna put it on the bow on the backside. So I'm gonna put my heel right here, my knee's coming across. This way, if you charge in on me as I have this knee up, you're gonna run into my heel rather than just my shin. So you're gonna run into this heel, which is gonna deter you from coming in a lot more. Now, as we kick out, I'm gonna allow my foot to hinge the bow out. I'm gonna pull back and I'm gonna set down, hopefully on balance. If you're losing balance a little bit, that's okay. Just try to keep your body upright. I'm gonna set my heel here, kick out, pull back, and then set down. So that's the basic idea with side kick. If you're not kicking out in a straight line, you're gonna notice immediately that you're doing it wrong. Take this really slow. Try to make it so that you don't go fast enough where it flings the bow up, just so you can work on really good controlled kicks. All right, last one, hook kick. Hook kicks are really versatile kicks. You can throw it on somebody who's standing right next to you or really far away from you. This one is gonna be for a longer hook kick, and this is just one way to do it. So I'm gonna bring, instead of my knee or my heel, I'm gonna bring my shin in line with the bow here. And the reason for that is that when I throw this kick out, it's gonna be almost like a round kick or a side kick off at this angle over here. So when I bring this up, I have the bow in front of me, I'm gonna bring my knee up so that my shin is in line with the bow, and then I'm gonna kick out. Now, as we get our leg extended, we're just gonna let it swing straight leg for a second back. So when I kick, let it swing straight back, and at the very end, that's when we bend our foot. So I'm gonna bring it up, out, and back this way, and then return with good control. If you don't do that little leg swing, just a quick tip here, you'll wind up bringing it back without actually throwing a good hook kick, and it's gonna be only a couple feet in front of you. So we wanna be able to reach this out and get that kick nice and long so we can reach the person at a distance that they can't counter punch us at the same time. All right, that's it. Try it out. Let us know what you think. Let us know your favorite drills or anything that we can help you with. Other than that, have a great time training and have an awesome day. See you in the next video. Peace.